Because the disciples know that those same powers that put Jesus on the cross, they're really going to be upset now. Because they thought they killed the Jesus movement. They crucified it. Jesus is dead and buried. Only now Jesus is back.
Praise the Lord.
And he's telling his disciples, I'm going home to the Father, but I'm going to send you the Holy Spirit, and you're going to go tell everybody that the cross is enough. You get to go tell them that their plan failed. Woo! Rome failed. Pilate failed. Yes. The chief priests failed.
Come on.
That's the message. Only that message terrifies the disciples, and it would terrify you too. You would not want to be the one to go and deliver that message. Think about it. It was just a couple of days earlier when the angry mob was shouting, "Crucify him!" How would you like to be the one to go back out into that city and tell that angry mob their plan didn't work? And Jesus is still on the loose. And by the way, I'm on his side.
Jesus now calls them his
names they're calling themselves. Failure, loser, coward. But Jesus doesn't call them that at all.
Praise the Lord.
Jesus just calls them brother.
Amen.
See, because he's giving them this new identity.
Ooh, thank you, Jesus.
They're not failures. They're not losers. They're not cowards.
Come
because
on.
Jesus just made them new again.
Praise the Lord.
They have this new identity. And this new identity, it's not based on their performance.
Amen.
Because God knows their performance was not very good. But this new identity is not based on what they have done.
Praise the Lord.
It's based on what he has done.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You see, the empty tomb didn't just make Jesus new again. It's making them new again. Just like Jesus, they've been resurrected to this new life.
Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Yes.
Let me show you something else very cool. Up until now, Jesus has always called God his Father. But look what Jesus says here now. Now he says, I'm returning to my Father and your Father. He never said that before.
Yes.
He says, my God and your God. He never said that before. And what that means is that you now have this new identity. Every one of you in Christ, you are this new person, and the new person can know the Father the same way Jesus knows the Father.
Praise the Lord.
It's like he opened up this door for you. He walked out of death and into life so that you could walk out of death and into life. He opened up this door for you, and he invites you to go in and become something more than you've ever been before.
Hallelujah!
I want to show you something else that's really cool while we're in this part of the story. And this also has something to do with Jesus making everything new again. And the women are going to love this part of the story. So in all four Gospels agree that the first people that Jesus showed himself to when he came out of the tomb were the women. All four Gospels agree. Jesus first showed himself to the women. Now that may not seem like a very important detail in our day, but in Jesus' day, that was radical. That is really countercultural. That is something that is really, really new. The first people, follow me now, first people that Jesus asked to be his witness,
come on,
are the women.
Woo!
Now here's what's so cool. Here's what's so new about that. Women were not allowed to be witnesses in that culture.
Amen.
Women were not even allowed to testify in a court of law because a woman's witness was not considered valid. Here's
Come
the thing.
On.
You could kill somebody and 100 women could watch you do it, and their testimony could not convict you because women were not allowed to be witnesses.
Come on.
But now Jesus is alive.
Ah!
And the first thing he does is tell the women they are going to be his
witness. Praise the Lord. Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Jesus is making everything new.
Amen. Come on.
Now, because women weren't allowed to be witnesses, what do you think is going to happen when those women go to the men and tell them Jesus is alive?
Come on.
What do you think is going to happen?
Come on.
Luke 24. must have felt. Because back up in the story a little bit. Let's just back up a few days. Jesus gets arrested. What do all the men do?
Run.
Woo! They're gone. They run, right? Jesus is lifted up on the cross. Who's there?
It's the women.
The women are there at the foot of the cross, weeping and mourning. That morning, they go to anoint his body. Who's there? Who's there to anoint the body of Jesus? It's the women. So, it's the women that Jesus first appears to. And then they go tell the men that Jesus is alive, and the men say, you're talking nonsense.
Come on.
Of course, just a short time later, Jesus does appear to the men. Now, guys, I don't know about the women in your life, but the woman in my life, she loves the opportunity to say, I told you so. now, she doesn't get that chance very often, you understand?
Oh! Never.
But when she gets that chance, she loves to say, I told you so. So, Jesus comes, he appears to the men. What do you suppose the women are thinking in that moment? My wife can tell you exactly what they're thinking. They're thinking, yeah, I told you so. Right? I told you so. Jesus is making everything new. The empty grave changes everything.
Yes, Lord.
It gives us this new identity. It gives us a new relationship with God. It gives us this new family with each other. It gives us something worth living for and something worth dying for.
Yes.
And the empty grave gives us hope when someone we love is in the hospital and we don't know if they're going to make it.
Right.
Now, they're still going to be hurt. There's still going to be sickness and suffering, and the hospital bed is still going to be there. It's just that now we know that those things are not the end of the story.
Right.
Amen.
You see, the ultimate story of Jesus is the story of two things. It's the story of the cross and the empty grave.
Yes.
The cross and the empty grave. But one leads to the other. And the only way to get to the empty grave is to go through the cross.
Yes.
I'm going to say that again because you've got to let that sink in. The only way to get to the empty grave is to go through the cross. Now, I say that again because that is not just the Jesus story. That's God's story for the whole world.
Yes.
And that can be your story too. The only way to the empty grave is to go through the cross. That's the story. And that certainly became the story for those first Christians. And that's why they started saying things like, I have been crucified with Christ and I no longer live. But Christ lives in you.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Do you see the message? Those first Christians are proclaiming to the whole world that they've got a new story now.
Yes.
That the empty grave is changing them. They have a new story. I certainly have a new story now. I hope you do too.
Yes.
Because there's this part of me that is selfish and sinful and dirty and all messed up. But I put all that stuff on the cross and this new Theo was born.
Woo!
So you wouldn't have to. And that's good. But when you abide in Christ for a while, then what you learn is that he died so that you could die with him.
Amen.
He was crucified so that I could be crucified with him. And what I'm talking about is that he that is ungodly, that sinful self, all those habits that I'm ashamed of, and I can't seem to stop them on my own, but I can put all those things on the cross, and Jesus sets me free from all of that stuff.
Praise the Lord. Praise God.
I am not what I once was. I'm becoming somebody new. And God already sees me as this new person. And that's why Jesus called me brother, sister.
Yes.
And see, that's what happens when the cross and the empty tomb come together. The old is gone, and the new has come.
Praise the Lord.
And that's exactly what the first church proclaimed. If anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation.
Praise the Lord.
The old is gone, and the new has come.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. I'm just going to close with this thought. I'm going to say one more time that the empty grave changes everything. It's changing me. And it doesn't mean that I'm perfect. God knows that that old self keeps trying to come back to life. But time is running out for that old self.
Come on.
Jesus calls me his brother. And he tells me that my sin and my fear and my shame and my failure, those things don't have to define me anymore because I've got a new story now. And it's a story that was born from a cross and an empty grave. Amen?
Amen.
Our invitation is so simple this morning. I'm just going to tell you this. What I'm going to do right now is get on my knees right there. And I'm going to thank God that my mother is alive and with me today. And I'm going to thank God that I've got a new story. Join me right here. And thank God.